In this video, I'm going to explain how the levels graph works and how you can read it properly. It's equivalent to a histogram in a Lightroom. It's pretty much the same thing as a histogram. I'm just going to make this graph a little bit bigger by going here. And I'm going to show you a different graph from this image. So I'm going to go right here and I'm going to explain the levels graph to you. So the main graph you want to look at is this gray area right here, which represents the luminance value or the black and white values of the exposure. So this represents like shadows right here on the left-hand side. The middle represents midtones, and the right side, it represents the whites. So looking at this gray graph right here in the front, it means that there's a lot of shadow pixels or dark areas, as well as a lot of white areas. And there's not as much midtones. In other words, where there's an exposure value of 50%. On the background or the back graphs here, you can see the RGB values. This just represents the RGB channel or the levels of the RGB channel. So there's a lot of blue shadows here, as well as some blue highlights or whites right here. And then there's the red, green, cyan is the complementary color, as well as yellow, but it looks like a little bit of brown here. And there's a little bit of magenta as well here. But overall, the main graph you want to look at is the gray one right here, which represents the luminance value. Now going back to this image here, I'm going to play around with the levels and show you what happens. And before I do that, while I move the mouse around here, you can see the RGB value change as I move the mouse around. And now you can see here, there's a little bit of gap here on this levels graph. So it's not pushed all the way to the left, and there's a little bit of gap here on the whites section here. So the best way to explain how it works is to go to the tone and color and watch what happens when I move the exposure to the right, the exposure slider. The levels graph pushes to the right. And if I push it to the left, the graph also goes to the left and makes the image darker. So you can see when there's a lot of parts of the graph on the left, it's dark. When it's on the right, it's too bright. And when it's evenly exposed, it looks a little bit better like this. But this isn't exactly evenly exposed because there's a little bit of gap here. So the darkest part is about 0 to 20% missing right here, same with the white parts. So to balance this out, what I need to do is change the black points and the white points. So I'm just going to move this white point to the right here. And now you can see this corner is just moving to the right, correcting the exposure. And then I'm going to move the black point a little bit to the left, balance it out. So let's see the before and after. So you can see it's a little bit better exposed, the image. Let me just turn that off. And now if I want to correct the shadows and highlights, I can adjust it right here. Just make the image look a little bit better. Now, there's no exact way of having a histogram or levels graph look because it depends on the artistic touch you're looking for. But generally, making the histogram or the levels graph look like this, it makes it look a little bit more evenly exposed. And by the way, disregard this horrible alignment to the horizon here. This is not a cropping tutorial. Now, another thing I want to show you is the clipping indicators. So I'm going to turn it on right here. And when I turn it on, let me make sure it's on. It's going to show you the values that are 100% black or 100% white. In other words, it's overblown. Let me just turn it on here. Okay, that looks good. So this red part here represents highlight clipping, which means it's 100% white and it has no detail. I can do the same here and move the exposure to the left and move the black point to the left. And now you can see there's shadow clipping. So usually you don't want too much shadow or highlight clipping. Otherwise your image may look a little bit overblown or underexposed. One thing I want to show you is how the contrast slider works. The contrast slider, it darkens the shadows and brightens the highlights. So once I increase the contrast, you can see the histogram or the levels graph. It's pushing away and it's evening out the exposure a little bit. It also adds a little bit more saturation just due to the contrast being changed of the highlights and the shadows. So now the other thing I can do with the contrast slider is push it to the left and it'll make the image soft. So it's messing up the exposure or the exposure level and it's not evenly exposed. So that's what happens when you don't have a good exposure on an image. Now there is a different type of levels graph that I want to show you. I'll go to the local adjustment and then I will click on add adjustment here. I'm going to turn on the luminosity masking. I'll show you the mask right here. So this is a mask right now. So I'm going to adjust this mask by changing the levels graph here. So I'm going to make the dark parts darker. And it's similar to how the levels graph works here. And I'm going to make the white parts whiter or brighter. So I'm just changing or aligning the mask, and then I can change the mid-tone levels as well. So now I'm going to turn off this mask, and now it's only going to, affect the highlights. So let me just reset this first. That looks better. Now I still have this mask active, and that looks good. So now I'm just going to go and play around with the highlight colors. I can change the temperature, make it a little bit cooler, or make it a little bit warmer, put a little bit of magenta, and give it a little bit more of an artistic touch. And that's pretty much it. So there's two types of levels. The main one is this one, equivalent to the histogram. And then there's the levels graph, or the levels slider to adjust the mask. And if you guys enjoyed this video, you know what to do. And as always, live easy, sleep breezy, and stay lovely.